Right, so last time we went through how quickly it can go wrong if you're eating out a lot, if you're not really watching what you're eating. This is how easy it is to make it go right, okay? This is just some very simple food changes, simple like tweaks in your diet, just making better decisions. This is really easy to apply. We could have gone through every single food. I could have written down hundreds of numbers, but I just want to make it as simple and as easy and as quick for you to understand it and apply it. Before we go into it, the two most important things with this, all these numbers are per 100 grams, okay? I'm sure you've probably heard the riddle, what weighs more, a ton of feathers or a ton of lead? They both weigh the same, because they both weigh a ton. However, for a ton of lead will be a lot smaller than a ton of feathers, okay? And it's the same with food. 100 grams of steak is probably a tiny little amount. That will not fill you up. Even if it looks good on the pack, 100 grams is nothing. Whereas 100 grams of lettuce is like three things of lettuce, okay? So the weight, there's a big difference between weight and size, okay? The second thing you need to bear in mind is some stuff is just more filling than others. Broccoli doesn't have a lot of calories and it fills you up quite a lot. Something like a pizza has a lot of calories and fills you up a lot. Something like a Coke has a lot of calories and doesn't fill you up at all, okay? So satiating, I believe is the technical word. You want something, ideally, that doesn't have a lot of calories and fills you up, okay? So just bear those two things in mind. I've tried to lay this out as simple as possible. So the first, biggest, easiest change to make is with your dinner, instead of having rice or pasta, have veg salad, okay? Again, these are 100 grams. If you were to have rice with your dinner, that is, these pens are terrible, 110 calories. If you were to have carrots or vegetables, say 41 calories. If you were to have lettuce, 15 calories, okay? So, again, in this example, you can have three times as much carrots versus rice, that'll fill you up a lot more, and it'll be the same amount of calories, or you can have less, and you'll save yourself 70 calories, okay? So, first big change you can make it easy for yourself, swap pasta, rice, for veg salad, okay? Don't have to cut it out completely, if you just did it twice a week, that would be a really good start. Second thing, fairly easy to do, snacks. Okay, again, this is per 100 grams. So, crisps, 100 grams of crisps is 550 calories. 100 grams of biscuits is 500, okay? That is not good. Okay, so, very easy, you can swap that for just beans on toast. 100 grams of beans, 151 calories, bread, one slice, 60 calories. You get little changes like this. You can then eat two of these, potentially, for less calories than it would be packing out on a bunch of biscuits. Okay, so again, just little tweaks. Breakfast is a big one. This is probably the biggest mistake most people make. You do not have to eat breakfast if you do not like it, if it's not natural, if it doesn't come to you. Again, we said before, pick a plan that works for you. So breakfast, the main reason you should have it is so you don't then pig out throughout the day. If you're organized, that will be good. But for argument's sake, let's say you like breakfast. Biggest mistake people will have, porridge or muesli or something like that. That's really good if you're trying to get stronger, get fitter, and it's all about the workouts. If you're trying to lose weight or tone up or lose inches, it's not, okay? So again, in this example, a bowl of porridge, 100 grams, is 374 calories. A plain yogurt is 63, okay? So you could have four yogurts for the same amount of calories as one bowl of porridge. Again, does it fill you up? That's more personal. You have to decide that for yourself. But you could essentially have a plain Greek yogurt at 7 in the morning when you wake up. You could have one at 11. You could have one when you get home from work. And you could have one before you go to bed. Four snacks, essentially, for less than just what your standard breakfast is. You could have a banana as well. You could have both. A banana and a plain Greek yogurt is half the amount of calories as a porridge, bowl of porridge. Little changes like that, okay? Yes, it needs to fill you up. and just be aware again of how much it weighs versus how big it is. But you can easily see, all you gotta do is have some salad with your chicken instead of rice, and a Greek yogurt instead of a porridge, and you're already saving yourself 500 calories a day, 3,500 calories a week, 2.5 days of food almost, just by those two changes, okay? So it is massive, it's really important. The last big one you can make is where, what kind of meaty stuff you have. If you're vegetarian, obviously you wouldn't have that. Just be aware that, again, carby stuff tends to have a lot of calories, so try and have more salad-y, veggie type things. Core mints and stuff like that is a good substitute. But a chicken breast is 195 calories, cod is 111, beef is 276. The thing that I have not put on there, because I forgot, is prawns. Prawns are around about 110, I believe, for the same amount. So, as a rule, the thing that's got the most amount of calories in it is red meat. Second, then go down, will be kind of chicken, fish, fairly equal. And the best thing is like crustacean-y, mussels, prawns, all that kind of stuff. So, again, if you just swap your beef to chicken, again, you save yourself another 80 calories, do that 10 days in a row, 80 calories, over half a day's worth of food, just by changing what you're getting it from. All these little tweaks make up to a big difference, and if you do them gradually, it is part of your lifestyle. It doesn't feel like you've changed much, it becomes natural, it's easy to stick to. Again, as you get fitter and stronger, then you can even eat more and still lose weight. A last one I'll just put down here, a large pizza is 3,300 calories, okay? Again, that comes back to how quickly you can go wrong. That is, I mean, just have a look. My mouth isn't great. A chicken breast is 195 calories, so 10. So you'd have to have 15 chicken breasts for the same amount of calories as this. If you just had 3 chicken breasts a day, you could probably last that a week. A week's worth of food in one thing. So, these are the big changes you can make. Better snacks, veg or salad instead of rice and pasta, yogurt and fruit for breakfast instead of porridge, fish and chicken instead of red meat. They're the big ones. There is so much more depth we can go into. These are a very personal thing though, so the best thing to do is to come in and talk, and we can go through what type of person you are, what you like, what you don't like, put a plan together. This is more to get you in the routine, okay? As you get fitter, get stronger, have more goals, you need to make it a bit more specific. One more video after this is just putting it all together, how making the changes, being consistent, bigs up, and the cumulative effect of it leads to you hitting goals. But hopefully that'll make sense. So we could have gone into 10 times more depth. These are just the main things that you can pretty much do now with no real knowledge of anything to start making progress.